Good morning. It is my great pleasure and honor to be here today and share some of the plans that we have for the health facility development and revitalization program for the National Department of Health in South Africa. Before I start my presentation, I would like to convey on behalf of Dr. Aaron Motsoaledi, the Honorable Minister of Health in South Africa, his well-wishing and success message to all of you and to this Congress and organizing committee. Unfortunately, he couldn't be with us today because of the accident of his wife. Otherwise, it was his plan to be here and present the keynote speak. The topic of our discussion is about integrated approach for revitalization of health facilities in the National Department of Health, National Insurance Pilot District in South Africa. As you know, you may have heard that there are 11 districts with the worst condition of health facility being chosen as the district for piloting the national health insurance in the country. The table of content after the introduction and background, I will share with you an overall health facility revitalization program and some cash flow analysis for the 11 national health insurance districts in South Africa. Then focus on the revitalization of 700 clinics in the NHI districts to ideal clinics, as it is termed by our primary health care section, and also building of 217 replacement and new ideal clinics in the NHI districts in the country. And my main reason focusing on the clinics is the fact that because of the non-functionality of very many of our primary healthcare, people are flocking and rushing to hospital. That's why our hospitals, especially district hospital, even tertiary hospital, are overcrowded, and the management thereof is a real nightmare and difficult. South Africa, with about 1.5 million square kilometer, has got a total of 4,300 healthcare facility. Although, as you know, the service delivery in the healthcare sector is profoundly affected by the built infrastructure provided to support it, but we have got serious challenges in terms of resources, severe staffing constraint in healthcare and built environment, legacy of the service platform, and also very slow replacement rate, about 40 years. That's the type of average age of our facility in the country. By way of introduction, the National Department of Health has the constitutional mandate and responsibility to provide South Africans with high quality healthcare services accessible to all its citizens. In broader terms, however, the NDOH has an important role to play in the socio-economic and political transformation of the country, the provision of effective state services and infrastructure, and in achieving sustainable economic growth. The National Department of Health embraces this responsibility by defining long-term strategy that are in line with the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa, which states the right to access to healthcare services, including reproductive health and emergency treatment. NDOH, with its provincial counterparts, invested billions, and every year we are investing billions of rands in the provision of infrastructure to achieve suitable access for health facility for South Africa. The department's responsibility for managing this infrastructure is proven in both the provision of new facility buildings and preserving the value of existing health facility by managing the life cycle cost, appropriate operation, maintenance and renewals of these infrastructure. This contributes directly to the better functioning of the health facility and improving accessibility to healthcare services. As I mentioned, 11 districts, one in each of the 9 provinces, except KwaZulu-Natal, where we have chosen 3 because of the high population, of the worst case status, have been selected to pilot the country's national health insurance program. This table shows us the name of these 11 districts in all the 9 provinces of the country, the number of clinics, community health centers, district hospital, various other types, regional, central, and others. As we can see here, the total number of facilities in the NHI district is about 872, which constitute close to 21% of the total facilities in the country. And the challenge is to pilot our betterment plan or ideal facility plan in these 11 districts. Just to share with you our annual performance plan, which is for a period of 5 years, as we call it APP, is a very ambitious plan. It covers clinic program, rehabilitation and building new clinic, primary health care program, hospital program, doctor's consulting room, emergency space provision for very small clinics in deep rural areas, nursing education institution revitalization program, maintenance and upkeep of the existing facility to the extent of covering all of them, and also support program that we will discuss. The total value of this ambitious program, as you can see here, with the cash flow for various financial years up to the year 23-24 financial year, is over 60 billion rand. If you look at this slide, we can see that there is going to be a total of 217 new and replacement clinic to the value of 5.4 billion rand already been planned. The program has started in last year, April, as you can see. And you can see the S-curve as to how the development with the cash flow attached to that will be implemented for the period of 5 years ahead of us. These are the community health centers at this stage, the first phase, 5 of them, as you can see the name, mainly in the Mpumalanga province of ours. And the total value is about 470 million rand altogether. Yes. And the total period, we are talking about 4.5 years or 54 months. Ambitious hospital replacement and revitalization program, 45 of them, of which 10 are on the planning and implementation stage. Some of them has already been started. 45 of them to the value of a total of 44 billion rand for a duration of 96 months, covering about 8 years. As you can see again, the S-curve and the financial allocation to that. The next program is the doctor's consulting room. Based on the study that we have done on the condition of all these, and we are still continuing with this program, it hasn't been completed as yet. District by district, we are assessing the construction, the planning, as well as the functionality of each and every facility in our NHI districts, defining what is wrong, to what extent, and at what cost, and how it can better be suited for purpose in terms of redesigning and doing an integrated type of planning and improvement program for them. Based on this program, we have found out that close to 120 of our clinics has got severe space problem. So what we have done, we have designed a certain type of a structure with the IBT technology, which is prefabricated type of technology, with mild steel type of structure and the fiber cement panels that, you know, based on a certain standard from our CSIR, we call it AGRIMA type of compliant certified type of construction in terms of, you know, building regulation of the country. And we are adding this space through this type of technology to the severely space shortaged clinics, all over these 120 clinics. This program is 24 months program, and in 2 years, we are hoping we complete this emergency work. This program, as I mentioned, has already been started in April last year. In terms of nursing education, in order to emphasize and also supplement our existing nursing complement in our health facility, we have to upgrade close to 125 of our existing nursing education institution, whether they are colleges or schools within the premises of the hospitals or outside them. It's a program, again, we have done a proper study of their status, and we come up with this master plan enabling us to make sure that they are upgraded to provide us with the sufficient number of nurses in various categories until 2025. This program is a five-year program. It's going to be costing us about $2.4 billion. We have already started it since April last year, and we are hoping within this period we will be able to complete this program. The maintenance program and upkeep program I will share with you in some detail, focus going to be on this one as well as on the new building of the clinics. As I mentioned, there is a large number of facilities in primary healthcare that need close to 800 of them, and we need close to 6.1 billion rand to revitalize these facilities. And the program is for 5 years, 60 months, and it has got three dimensions of maintenance of the existing one, and then replanning and redoing it in such a way that is better suited for purpose, and also additional space and facility that is going to be added to these as part of this integrated program. In terms of support program, you know, there are several support programs like PMIS, Project Management Information System, which is already in place, program management support services in order to do a proper quality quantity control in loco supervision, so on and so forth, as part of the professional manpower setup to make sure that what is being designed, what has been implemented, do serve the purpose for which this design has taken place. This is going to be for the whole duration of all this program. This is a summary of the total amount of money and the cash flow that I shared with you. There are over 60 billion rand for the duration of between 5 to 8 years. Very briefly, three major projects, we call them mega project, mega hospital project, The first one is King Edward VIII in Durban. It's going to be three of them actually all together. And the total value of this is close to 11 billion rand. We have already started the pre-planning process for this hospital, and I'm hoping we will be able to share better progress next year when we see each other in Johannesburg. The second mega project is Dr. George Mukhari Hospital in Gauteng. As I mentioned, is one of the huge hospital, and again, we are at the preliminary or pre-planning stage, and very soon we are hoping that we would be able to complete it, you know, close to 7 to 8 years, this mega project hospital. And the Limpopo Academic, which will be coinciding with the establishment of the medical school in our Limpopo University. That's going to be a forum where our medical students in Limpopo are going to be getting their practical training there. And we are hoping that by next year, May, we will be on construction. The total value of these three mega projects with the cash flow that I shared with you is close to 21 billion rand. And again, that's the summarized cash flow. Now, focusing on the clinics, these are the type of guideline that we have received and we are receiving in close collaboration with our primary healthcare section within the department. For our upgrading as well as building of the new clinics, these are the norm that we are following in terms of a space for the number of consulting room based on the burden of disease and the number of people that are visiting the areas. You know, the basic fundamental statistics run, and in a summarized way, that is the guideline we are going to be following. Unfortunately, this is not that much legible. Based on our norms and standard and guide for design and planning and implementation of our health facility that has been completed within 3 years, and some of the colleagues who were participating in the development of this guideline are here participating here. We can have detailed discussion also with them. The list of rooms for a small clinic, medium and large clinics, as we call them, ideal clinic, and the space are reflected, and that is what is a guideline we are following in our implementation of the upgrading as well as building new ideal clinic, especially in deep rural areas. You know, the size, the total space for the very small we are talking about, including the circulation space, over 600, for the small ones 731, for the medium 1,095, and the large one close to 1,500 square meter. Just as an example, in Eastern Cape, which is a very, very deep rural areas, there are close to 160 clinics. You can see the left side circled in the red is an existing layout of the existing clinic. You know, you are talking about two consulting rooms there. But based on this new guideline that is being approved by our primary healthcare, you can see on the right, we are adding close to just over 200 square meter and also another 83 square meter to turn it into the ideal clinic based on the need of the area. This is a sort of medium size or a small to medium size clinic, the way that the rehabilitation and addition is going to be taking place. Firstly, we on the left side, what's going to be happening over and above the maintenance, routine maintenance that we will be doing, we will be doing some modification of the existing setup to make it more suitable for operation, and then addition, the services that are lacking at this stage, like acute, you know, and other MOU, so on and so forth, is gonna be added to that, and also the sort of multi-purpose meeting room for the community, so on and so forth, is gonna be added to that. This is for the small one, very small one clinic. Similar setup is gonna be done in Eastern Cape, deep rural areas. What we have done in terms of contractual arrangement, as you can see, they are color-coded. All these clinics are categorized and packaged for the whole, this one is, of course, the Western Cape, for the whole 57 clinics in for revitalization. And you can see it divided into three, Group A to Group C, with the total contractual cost of over 185 million rand. In Eastern Cape, a total of 152 clinics and CHCs are packaged, as you can see in these photos. The total value is over 573 million rand as different contractor for lot one is already in place. You can see this particular one that we have already started in Eastern Cape is close to 95 billion rand worth of project that has already been started. And one of the major areas that we are focusing in terms of construction and participation of the local labor and local contractors and supplier is to devise means to improve the situation of the SMMEs in these deep rural areas. As you can see, contractually, the main contractor is obliged to provide right up to 35% of the total value of the contract in favor of SMMEs in the particular region where they are working. This is contractually obligated, and a smaller type of contractor will be able to improve their performance and their grading with the CIDB, which is a center for the construction industries grading. These are a few slides of the activity that the contractor are busy providing in deep rural areas of the province. These are some schematic photos of the addition that I talked to you about. Option one is the fiber cement panel, which will be attached, as I said, to the existing clinic. The option B, the same type of panel, but with the brick, face brick, you know, just to make sure the environment is kept the same as the existing one. And of course, the option C, the shiplap fiber cement boarding, we will be attached again to the existing setup. Two hospitals in Eastern Cape as pilot, we have already started the planning of it, namely Bambisana Hospital in Eastern Cape, together with Zitsulele. Pre-planning has already been started, and we are hoping that during the course of next year, the actual construction will start. For the implementation of the new clinic in the NHI district, the 217, these are sort of standardized drawings, design that you can see is a courtyard basis. We have got one part, the chronic, acute, and also for the MCWH and MOU on the site for the clinic, with the central shared area in the middle. And these are the circulation pattern within the clinic. Yeah. We are at the design stage, final design stage. As I mentioned, very soon we are gonna go on construction. Staff accommodation is a matter of must in deep rural areas, and we have to provide, otherwise we won't be able to attract nurses and doctors in rural clinics. Similar pattern for the small clinics, the same type of principle that we are following. Construction, as I mentioned, has already been started, and we are hoping that we will be able to finish within 5 years the full set of 217. Thank you.